Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, lesson number 5. The topic it is internal land forming processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson course today, we are going to look at the evidence of the continental drift theory. In our previous lesson, we discussed about the continental drift theory according to the Alfred Wanja, where we said it was initially one Pangaea and the Pandarasa, which was the water. Then it split into two, and then it split into the current continents. Now, let us look at the evidence that supports that. One, we have the jigsaw fit of the continent margins. And an example, we have the eastern coast of the South America and western coastline of Africa. They can merge together when they are brought together, like the way you can be able to see them. So that is one of the evidence that support the continental drift theory. Not only that, even if you go to the Europe and North America, if at all you bring them together, they can match. So that is the jigsaw fit of the continental margins. And that is an evidence these continents were initially one. Then we go to the next point, where now we have the similar geological structures between the rocks, or similar geological structures. When we look at the rocks that are found in Brazil, it is in South America, and the ones that are found in the Republic of South Africa, which is in Africa, these rocks are similar. Look at the image. As you can be able to see, the Brazil, which is in South America, and the South Africa, which is the Republic of South Africa in Africa, you can be able to see that geological structures are similar. Even if you look at that map where we have the Caribbean similar, if I try bring it together, there is an indicator that this continent was initially one. So you can be able to trace the geological structures. They can share from one continent to the other. So we also talk about the next, which is the next evidence that supports the continental drift theory. We have the marching folded mountain ranges. If I try to look at them where they are found, and they are found in different continents, for example, you have the Appalachians, and we have the mountain that is found in North Africa, and also in Eurasia. We also have another one in Greenland and Norway. Those ones, if at all you bring them together, they were formed in the same time, and that one is an evidence that these was joined together and it was formed at the same time. The same case, if at all you look at the Cape Verde belts, and the one that is found in South America, that is also another indicator that this continent were joined together one time. The other point, it is the Paleozoic glacial deposit that is found widely dispersed in continents of the India, Australia, and also the South America. If I try to look at these ones, all these continents, the three of them, came from the Gondwanaland, which was in the southern hemisphere, or that moved in the southern hemisphere. And you are going to get the glacial deposit found in the continent. You can be able to see where they are located. South America. We also have some in Africa. When you go to India, when you go to Australia. And they have a certain area. If I try to bring it together, they can join. together. Another evidence, it is the seafloor spreading. The seafloor spreading. Young rocks are in the middle of the ocean, while older rocks found near their coast, like the way you can be able to see. We have the older rocks are found just next to the mid-Atlantic Ocean, and the youngest are at the middle, while the oldest are at the coast. So that is another evidence that support the continental drift theory. Then we also have the paleontological evidence. The similarities of the fossils in the southern continent, that is the South America, Africa, India, Australia. These fossils is an indicator that this continent were initially one, if I tell you look at the fossils. Like that way you can be able to see them. They are distributed in a certain area. Then we also have the climatological evidence. Core today is found in temperate latitudes, but they are believed to have been found in tropical climates. Look at the core, distribution of the core. South America, Africa, India, and also Australia. You can be able to see, if I tell you bring them together, they can join very well. And then we have the paramagnetic evidence. And this one shows the similarities in the magnetic alignment in minerals. For example, I have the diagram there that is giving us the normal magnetic, the polarity, and the reversed magnetic polarity. So you can be able to see it. So those are some of the evidence that support the continental drift theory. Activity for today's lesson, state for evidence that support continental drift theory. For more information, visit the KLB 2003 secondary student book tab, that edition. For more information, you can contact us through the SMS, your SMS to that number, through the YouTube, or through the Facebook, and also you can be able to tutor us. Otherwise, stay tuned to the Erin TV. Thank you.